So today's been a busy day.
At Dominion Creek, Parker's crew are pushing the boundaries of their new wash plant, Roxanne, in its first full week of running.
Right now, I'm still getting used to the new plant. Tyson and Mitch put a conveyor at the end that basically shoots out the coarse tailings, so we don't have to do it, which means now I can go get paved from a lot longer distances.
Tatiana Costa feeds the plant 250 yards of pay an hour.
Every plant has its corks, so I'm just right now figuring it out, what are the corks.
Alec!
We need to turn the feed rate up.
Yep.
I want to run it at, like, full cork.
Is there enough water?
We really need up 20%.
Okay.
Parker bumps Roxanne's feed rate up to 300 yards an hour. And Alec boosts the water being pumped into the plant from 2,800 to 3,000 gallons a minute to wash the increased dirt now flowing through.
I went up about 20%.
Yeah, no worries. The belt is much faster than what we were running before, so yeah, I really need to move a lot faster and speed up. Hey, Mitch, you got a copy, Mitch?
Yeah, go ahead, what's up?
Just to let you know, there's some water coming out of the distribution box. It's coming all the way to the floor, so I'm not sure if it's something we should be concerned.
I'm on my way, I'll come have a look at it.
What RPM you got, Alec?
She all maxed out.
Parker just upped it.
Parker decided he wanted to make some adjustments on the plant. We had it working what I thought was pretty good. And now this thing's probably running at 20% over capacity and it's spilling everywhere. You just gotta be patient with it, you gotta work through it. And you know, patience is one thing I don't think Parker has much of.
By increasing the feed rate and water flow, Parker's flooded the distribution box.
As you can see here, this plant's just really struggling. You can see the material boiling over. That's not a good thing. All that water coming out, well, it means erosion. The last thing we want is this wash plant pad to get too up and have to pull the plant out of here and rebuild it.
Mitch needs to strike a balance between a smooth water delivery while still having enough to wash the increased pay dirt through the plant.
I'm going to leave the feed rate where it is, and I'm going to change a couple nozzles in the pre-wash. We're going to just change kind of where the water's spraying, how the material hits, how the water spreads. That affects everything down here. So we're just gonna shut the plant down quickly here.
Hey, Tatiana, you got a copy?
Yeah, copy.
Hey, why don't you go ahead and let your feeder run out?
Yeah, no worries.
So what I'm gonna do is put some of the nozzles around these bars. This will help spread the water, and I'm hoping by spreading the water, it's gonna spread the material out as well. But we need to do this quickly and get the plant back running, because it's not doing nothing here while we're working on it.
Roxanne's custom-built spray bars are wide open, causing the plant to overflow. Mitch plans to attach flared nozzles to all of the spray bars. This will help break up and wash the increased rate of pay dirt with less water. If the right spread can be achieved, it should result in clean rocks and a reduced water flow.
by putting these nozzles on here with this flare, it's gonna help spread the water out a bit, kind of creating a wall to spread the material. We're gonna see what that does. Tatiana, you got a copy?
Let's throw some dirt at this thing.
Awesome, thank you.
Mitch can now turn the pump back down to 2,800 gallons a minute while maintaining the feed rate at 300 yards an hour.
Fire in the hole! We're just looking at the plant here after making the modifications. The water here in our distribution, it's a lot happier than what it was, and it seems to be spreading the material a little bit better. If you look down here, the water going through the runs, much more even. Looks a lot happier here. No more problems.
Hey, Mitch.
What up?
Sorry for the hang up.
Oh, no worries. I don't even think Tyson's gonna make it down tonight. So we made some adjustments on Roxanne.
I love that name.
Adjusted feed rate, adjusted water. It was a lot of fun, but definitely a challenge. Because like, yeah, you're like wide open material, wide open water.
Walk away.
Yeah, walk away.
I'm gonna go get a thermos.
Is there some gold here?
Yeah, we're gonna weigh some gold. So this is Australia Creek, all right? This is Tyson's little baby.
Slucifer's been running on Australia Creek for a month, averaging 145 ounces a week.
50. 150, 200, 230, 260, geez, 270.05.
That's not a bad week.
Worth over $540,000. Next up, Roxanne in the money pit.
Roxanne is definitely, you know, it's got a lot of potential. Is it as good as Big Red? It had a decent run. We had a little bit of downtime as we were making our modifications, but this should be a really good example of what Roxanne's capable of.
Before swapping in Roxanne, Big Red was Parker's main moneymaker, averaging over 370 ounces a week.
All right, we got 30, 40, 50, 60, 100, 150, 180, 190, 199, 200. Straight up.
So there's 200 straight up. And this is just to kind of like the remainder of it.
Okay. Here we go. We got another 30, 60, 70, 80, another 100, 130, 140.
The remainder, Chris?
Right? 200. More than the first one. 220, 246.85.
Plus the fine stuff that I couldn't clean.
So we got 200 in that pan, and then we got another 253.8.
A total of 453.8 ounces.
That's nearly 120 grand a day.
So we got three pans of gold there.
A 700 ounce week?
723.85 ounces. Over 700 ounces in 1 week.
That's nuts.
The biggest haul of the season, worth $1.4 million.
That's a hell of a result.
That's a really good week. We're on track. We're really on track. This just might work.
That's pretty cool.
And so our season total, 5789.95.
Like, the more gold that comes out of there, the more I'm like, oh, like, this is the ground. And not just we happen to start in a really good spot, right? It's so nice. Like, it was at first it was just relief, but now I'm like actually starting to get excited.
Can you imagine though if you had Big Red and Roxanne side by side?
Oh my God, I'd go on strike.